Happy Australia Day to you too, Chris. It's been a great day thus far. Got up early, went for a ride around town, and then spent 2 hours with the local council with new Australian citizens, watching them take their oaths of allegiance to this country. And I'm going to head after this interview down to the beach and have a few sausages and enjoy the occasion with family, friends and the community.
Fantastic. That's what the day is all about, enjoying this great country, celebrating it and striving, I suppose, committing to improving it as we go along. Do you think that the activists who want to change the date have already lost? Well, we seem to have the debate each year, but to me it's lost a bit of gusto. And with some prominent and respected Indigenous leaders like Warren Mundine and Jacinta Price and others saying that, hey, they love Australia Day too, it seems to have been more broadly accepted now by just about everybody.
That's right. And we've had so many new migrants over the last 30 years. They're part of our story now and they've embraced Australia Day. If you walk a couple of hundred metres from my office right here, you'll see a sea of Australian flags, lots of people celebrating, lots of boats out on the water. I think the general population, mainstream Australia, love Australia Day. And the flag says it all. Liberty under law, our beautiful geography and our federal character as a country. That's why they love flying it. That's why my kids are asking for flag tattoos. And that's why we celebrate together as a country on January 26.